This is my 1.6 HDI Peugeot partner engine, and just wanted to show you what I'm using to really test my battery and if it's good condition, if it needs replacing or charging, topping up, and generally if it's a good condition, what kind of tester I'm using. So in order to test my battery, I'm using this Foxwell. Let me hold it properly. Foxwell BT100 Pro. It's fairly simple. It's fairly simple device. Doesn't need batteries, so it's actually pretty cool. It's got two clamps, and I'll plug it in now, and I'll show you how this operates. So basically, they're color coded. First to the positive, then to the negative, and it'll light up straight away. There we go, and maybe I should switch off the light and then could be kind of seen a bit better. So if one presses the enter, so it shows how much current voltage is, 12.97 volts. If you press the enter here, one can go in the menu. I'm trying to rotate it somehow that it could be visible. So there is a battery test, then there's some arrows to go up and down. The view results, it's a preview result, language, you can choose a variety of languages, and escape to go back. And then the other is a version or info, so this is the version or info. Not really something that's quite interesting. So to go in the battery test, so the two options, so if it's in vehicle, so currently the vehicle is connected to the battery, so it is in vehicle, but if it's disconnected from the vehicle, it's out of vehicle. And there is a slight difference. I'll test both just to see. There is a bit of a difference whether it's in vehicle or out of vehicle. So if you click on vehicle, and then my battery is regular, but the AGM and gel, so my battery is regular, so I don't really have where to unscrew it to top up with liquid. So if I click on enter. So the variety of measures that one can measure, so I'll be using CCA, let me put some light. So my battery, you can't quite see, but it says 760 cold cranking amps. This is the battery ID EA770, but otherwise it's 760 cold cranking amps. I suspect you can't quite see that, so it's easier just to switch it off. So I'll use, but there are a variety of features here, a variety of standards that one can use, whatever it's more convenient. But I'll use cold cranking amps, and my battery is 760 cold cranking amps, so I'll click OK on that. So if very quickly it tests and gives the result, so it's currently 12.98 volts, and it measured, I'm trying to turn it somehow, it can be seen, 664 cold cranking amps out of 760 rated. Well, that's what you input, so that's quite a bit low, and this battery is about 2 years old, just under 2 years old, so it has dropped quite a bit. And I say there is a bit of a difference between in vehicle and outside the vehicle. So this is one out of two. So in the second menu, one can see state of health, SOH, 73% is the state of health, so it's dropped quite a bit. But as far as I remember, when I bought the battery and tested with this tester, it was roughly about 85%, so it hasn't really dropped. So state of current is 100%. And this RES MR, this is actually the resistance within between the cells, so it measures in milli ohms. So that's actually internal resistance, 4.73 milli ohms. And the state of health is not entirely clear how it's measured. There are no information. Most likely it's sort of measuring the impedance between the different cells, so it somehow relates this to what should be 100% state of health. But this is not, there is not really that much standard, but generally that's an impedance. So this is it, 73% state of health, and let's see, first menu, 664 cold cranking amps. So I'll now disconnect the two battery posts and just remove it so it's not connected to the car, and see what this actually shows. positive, negative. And I'm using just an 8mm wrench, so just force the negative, so I don't really short anything. And I'm fairly prepared. I have a one glove just to put inside when I take it off, so it doesn't really short anything. So I can put it inside and put it down there. And for the positive, I have a quick release clamp, but also have a small sock, so I can put it in. Kind of not really, just to be on the safe side, not really to touch anything on for a good measure. Also have a glove, so kind of to isolate if it touches anything, but well, that's not really that much of a problem. So now currently the battery is really outside of the vehicle, so I can really connect again the tester, the positive and the negative, of course, lights up straight away. I can switch that off so it could be slightly more visible, so 12.98, so pretty much the same volts. So if I do battery test, and this time it's out of the vehicle, regular cold cranking amps, 760 cold cranking amps, and it's testing. So last time it's 664, and this time it's 750 cold cranking amps. And I know this battery is really quite good, it hasn't let me down at all, and it cranks pretty quick. So outside the vehicle, there is some compensation inside the instrument, and I probably believe more the outside of the vehicle rather than inside of the vehicle. So on the next menu, well, last time was 73%, now it's 79%, and the resistance, I think, has dropped a bit. So there is a bit of a difference with this measures, whether it's connected to the car or it's not connected to the car. I know the car doesn't really have any parasitic draw of electricity, so the next thing is really I'll disconnect those and I'll actually charge up the battery with a charger, just to see whether these values will improve. So I'll keep it overnight. So currently it's 7 o'clock in the evening, so I'll keep really this overnight. It'll probably 10 o'clock in the morning, so 15 hours or so, just to see if these values will improve. To charge my battery, I really use Halfords battery charger. It's fairly simple, up to 2 liters, and it has a initial high charging, and then it goes to, I think, a couple of hours, goes on discharging, and then on ready and maintaining, so it's kind of a trickle charge. 15 hours charge time based on 16 amp battery, so that probably should be more for mine. It's also not suitable for stop and go or start and stop. So it has a switch for standard and sealed, so mine is sealed, so it doesn't really, you don't really top up the fluid. So at the end, it really has 2 crocodile clips, so you can plug it in the battery. So connecting the positive, I haven't yet switched on the charger. I'm just connecting those first positive and the negative. And this says charging, or this has lit up charging, but it's just getting power from the battery. So just switch it on. And the red thing, I mean, I'm not too sure yet. If I put some shadow on it, the red thing has lit up, so it says power, and currently it's charging. So this is really higher amps charging, and in 1 hour or something, it will switch to ready and maintaining. So it's a trickle charge. So I'll leave this overnight. I'll see how many hours. So we'll see if the Foxwell BT100 will report different state of health and state of current 100%, but state of health internal resistance, if I can improve those numbers. So I've had the battery charger for about 17 and a half hours, so it's really time to switch it off and see if these numbers have improved. switching off first the negative and the positive, taking it out. So again, the Foxwell BT100, let's see what if these numbers can improve. So there is a surface charge, so there is a surface charge from the charging, so hopefully the battery tester will say that you need to put on the lights in order to remove the surface charge, but let's see if this will work out. Positive and the negative should light up straight away. Yes, it does. Let's switch off the light. So 13.7 volts. Let's see, it should say battery test, auto vehicle. It doesn't really. I mean, I said that there is a difference. Only there is only a difference, not that much difference if you run it out of vehicle, this particular menu. But it's only a difference if the car is actually connected to it. So let's say out of vehicle, regular CCA 760 cold cranking amps, and it's working. It's working. It doesn't say about the service charge. So volts 13.68, 711 cold cranking amps. So it didn't really improve that significantly out of yesterday it was 715. Let's see the second menu, 78.70. Well, yesterday was 79%. So not really that much of a difference. 100% state of current and 4.43 resistance between the cells. So in milliohms. So it didn't really quite significantly improve it, so I suspect that that's about it. It states it's 78%. So now really connected. Yeah, let's switch this off. So now really this light disconnect though. So really connected to the car, and first you need to flick without running anything, not opening. So that's why before doing that, the window has to be down in order to be able to flick the lights just on side lights or full side lights, just to wake up the BSI and ECU in the car. And then I'll really do the same test when the vehicle inside, see, compare again let me show this. So this was 713, what was it, battery test, let's say in vehicle, regular CCA 760, so it will be roughly about the same, it will be no difference. So 715, well, there's a bit of a difference, plus minus some, 79%, that wasn't really that much, or there is some variability there, but not really that. Let's do this again. Let's say out of vehicle, regular CCA 760. So 717 is not really that much of a difference, plus minus a few. So probably the surface charge has gone out a bit, but it's only slightly, is varying only slightly, couple of. So there is not really that much of a difference between out of vehicle and in vehicle within this parameter. It only matters whether the car is connected or not. So I'll connect the first the positive and then the negative. The quick release clamp and then the negative. And I'll light up with a 8mm. So the car has been connected and I've flicked the side lights on. So I'll really wait a few minutes in order for the car really to shut down and there will be no any drawing of any power, and then I'll test it to see if how this is different. So I waited a while. I'll connect the positive so it's in car. And then the negative. So this lights up straight away, so let's switch it off so it will be a bit more. So battery test. It doesn't matter whether it's out of vehicle, let's say in vehicle, I'll test it again outside the vehicle. Regular CCA 760. Let's see what will show if it's not connected. So there we go, 649 cold cranking amps, and it was 715 when it wasn't connected to the car. Second menu, 72% state of health, and state of current 100%, 4.84 resistance. So this slightly increased. So same thing if I really do out the vehicle. It will be about the same. It won't be that much of a difference. There you go, 646, roughly about the same, 71%. What's really the verdict? I would do this. It's really good device. I mean, I've been measuring. I've had it for about 2 years now, and it works quite well. Apart with the only problem is when it's connected to the car or not. So there is probably some current that somewhat reduces this resistance. There is something going on. So I would generally do it. I'll take it out. The terminals will take it out and then measure it. And that's a lot more accurate because I really know this battery is it's quite good. So there we go, that's a quick, well, not that quick anymore, review of this Foxwell BT100. So all the stuff in the, all the things are in the description of the video, so you can check it out. But they're all fairly similar, so I mean, I've been using this for quite a while, it's alright, and I can measure really kind of whether my battery is going or not. That's it. Thank you very much indeed for watching. Let me know for any comments in the comment section. I can try other stuff if you have any suggestions. Hopefully that was useful to someone. Let me know for any comments. Subscribe. Thank you very much indeed for watching.